Hey, what's up, guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. Well, for the first time in a while now, I believe that we have direct evidence of the ongoing cover-up of UFOs. And I'm not talking about some stuff that happened in the 60s or 70s. And I know that it can be frustrating for a lot of you guys, including myself, to know deep down that something is going on. You look at all the evidence, you look at all the testimony, the whistleblowers, the strange happenings going on around the world. And you say to yourself, how could there not be something going on? And what I'm about to tell you here, in my opinion, is concrete evidence that UFO sightings and the reports of them that are occurring right now and over the past few years are deliberately being covered up. This comes after a new report has revealed that basically a secret UFO sighting dossier, or in other words, a list of reports, is being hushed up and kept quiet by the British and European governments. And so there's this secret database, basically, that is filled with UFO incidents that have been reported by airline crews and pilots, and it's being kept from prying eyes using this very obscure law. And so the report states, originally reported by The Sun, that the public may never learn of the recent UFO sightings made by pilots in our skies thanks to a piece of EU legislation. Airline staff report a number of strange sightings to the Civil Aviation Authority, or CAA as we'll call it, every year since the Ministry of Defense closed its UFO desk in 2009. The CAA has become the last British government organization to retain an interest in UFOs and keep files on incidents involving civilian air crews. But it has decided not to release a dossier detailing sightings or incidents between the years of 2011 to present. So government files of this kind are normally available under the Freedom of Information Act, which allows any member of the public to request files from the government. But the CAA is now using a piece of European legislation from 2014 to block access to its record of, quote, occurrences. It states, and I quote, "Occurrence information can only be used for the purpose of maintaining or improving aviation safety, and the release of occurrence information to the general public or the media, including in response to Freedom of Information Act requests, is not permitted." It then goes on to state, quote, "However, if you require occurrence information for the purpose of maintaining or improving aviation safety, you are able to make an application to the CAA." So, just to stop here, in a nutshell, the British government is using this obscure and little-known European law in order to keep us from having access to these UFO sighting files. So, one of the main purposes of this legislation is to protect the identity of pilots who come forward to share details of strange sightings in the sky. However, for those of you who have ever filed a Freedom of Information Act request, information obtained using such are usually redacted to remove any identifying features like names and addresses, so that really wouldn't apply here. A man by the name of Dr. David Clark of Sheffield Hallam University's Department of Journalism has previously been granted access to the files, but was shocked when his Freedom of Information Act request was refused earlier this year. Now, you're seeing some photographs here that have been released from the Ministry of Defense of some of these UFO sightings that have been occurring since 1976. Here's one from Heathrow from 1993. Where in which pilots described a UFO, as you're seeing here, where they could actually see through a transparent ceiling on this thing and actually visibly see bodies looking up at them. And it should also be noted that for many years, the CAA has released this information under the Freedom of Information without any evidence that commercial secrets or safety have been harmed or compromised. In 2012, the chief executive of Britain's National Air Traffic Control Services admitted in a BBC Radio 4 interview that his agency indeed does receive reports of UFOs from the civil air crew every single month from all around the world. But then they seem surprised that curious individuals might want to see details of these incidents using open government legislation. And now they are using a piece of European regulation to block public access to these records. The only conceivable reason for this change of policy is embarrassment on the part of the aviation industry. It does not want to admit that its pilots do occasionally report things in the sky that are difficult to explain. The report then states that when quizzed about this, the Civil Aviation Authority told the Sun Online that the files were available if you could, quote, prove you were going to use the info to further safety in the sky. So it's basically a catch-22 because it's still not available to journalists or the general public. It is unclear whether Brexit will open up the files to the public again, but there's a 2-year wait until the divorce is settled. And there you have it. So to recap here, the Ministry of Defense and the CAA has in the past admitted that they receive a list of reports from pilots and air crews from all around the world, noting strange occurrences and UFO sightings that cannot be explained. Originally, they would release these files should anyone from the public file a simple Freedom of Information Act request. But even then, you would usually get files from back in the day, stuff that's so old, it's inconclusive. And now, with these newer UFO sightings that have occurred from 2011 all the way up to now, they are suddenly blocking them and depriving the public of data and information that they have a right to have access to. So again, I say, if this is not proof positive of the ongoing UFO cover-up, then I don't know what is. And I've found, in many cases just like this instance here, that evidence doesn't always come in the form of a UFO flying across the sky caught on video, but indirectly. And I've learned that you can expose just as much from watching the government squirm and attempt to hide these files as you could from simply capturing a UFO on video. This is a very important story to note. I want you guys to share it, let people know about it, and hopefully we can put some pressure on the CAA to release these files and stop blocking them using some nonsense law that doesn't even apply. And I will link to the original report down in the video description, so check it out and let me know what you guys think. Now, before we go today, I've got a few shoutouts here. So first, I want to wish a happy belated birthday to one of Secure Team's biggest, littlest fans. This is George, and George just had a birthday. I got an email from his father a couple months back who indicated that his son is a big fan of the channel and that it would just make his son's day if he could have a Secure Team sticker on his birthday. So I sent him an autographed sticker out, and on his birthday, or a few days after, I received this picture back of George with his sticker, enjoying his birthday. And again, I want to say thank you guys for being such awesome fans, and happy birthday to the little man here. I hope you like the sticker and that you had an amazing birthday. So while we're on the topic of super fans, you guys are really going to like this. A viewer of mine surprised me on Twitter when he sent me a picture of his brand new Secure Team tattoo. And these photos were taken, I mean, literally right after it got done. So it hasn't healed yet, but I wanted to feature it because it's so cool. I mean, I really don't know what to say other than I'm honored that you'd want to represent and give me free publicity for life. But yeah, it is a cool logo. You know, I've been thinking about getting a tattoo myself of it. I mean, who wouldn't want a cool alien logo, you know, regardless of the channel? So it is really cool. And I wanted to give a shout out to the tattoo artist that did it, who goes by the name of Kyle Kun at Organic Ink Tattoo in Connecticut. So shout out to him for the cool work. And we're going to keep rocking and rolling. So thank you guys again. I hope you guys enjoyed your 4th of July. I'm a little deaf this morning. My fingers are a little burnt from lighting off so many fireworks. But that's how we do it over here in the good old US of A. So thank you guys for stopping by. Be sure to email me if you have your own interesting story or UFO sighting. And I'll see you all back in just a bit.